You can never whip these boys if you don't keep you and them separate. I found that out in Birmingham. You've got to keep the white and the black separate.
If we can get a breakthrough in Birmingham and really break down the walls of segregation, it will demonstrate to the whole South, at least the hardcore South, that it can no longer resist integration.
I wish I knew how it would feel to be free. I wish I could break all the chains holding me.
September 15th, 1963 was one of the darkest days in the civil rights movement. Four young black girls, aged 11 to 14, were killed when a bomb exploded at the 16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama.
The last hour of my life, I enjoyed a lot. I learned a lot of new things, being in the homeland of Martin Luther King Jr., and I got to see a lot of new facts that went along with segregation. And I there were a couple things I knew, including the Rosa Parks story and the Martin Luther King speech, but I got to actually see in depth how those things actually transpired. So that was very interesting. And then being here with the group of guys that I work with every day and basically created a culture and a family here just made the hour that much better.
The museum really kind of opened my eyes, and the fact that a lot of the facts I didn't know, just like all the meetings and stuff that they held behind the scenes.
It served as a meeting place for civil rights organizers.
And it really opened my eyes to see how many people were truly affected and all the effects of the segregation and how serious segregation really was.
My impressions on the museum, man, it was actually great. Taught me a lot. I already knew a couple things about what was going on with the civil rights, but the museum taught me a lot more, and just a great experience, and I was just blessed to be here.
And to be here with all my teammates and all my closest family besides my actual family was it really meant a lot to share this experience with them.